On the eve of Guy Fawkes, the raging scrub fire that tore through a Canterbury settlement has reignited the debate on whether fireworks should be for public sale. Officials have confirmed fireworks sparked the blaze and there are tinder dry conditions across the country. Donna Marie Lever reports.
Here we go again. Fireworks are back, and on the eve of Guy Fawkes and the chaos and carnage that can come with it, should they still be for sale?
As long as people are doing it safe and all that, I don't see why not.
It's a bit of fun, isn't it? You know, everybody knows to put their cats and dogs and stuff away.
But, like, restrictions maybe? Banning, no.
That's better done by, like, people who actually know what they're doing.
Yeah, they should be banned.
Let the children enjoy themselves.
Calls are stronger than ever to ban fireworks from public sale. After news, they were behind this week's Canterbury blaze.
We don't want to see people driving around in cars, which we've had over the previous years, letting them off like that. Be sensible. If this isn't a warning for the public, I don't know what is.
Many places across the Motu, especially in the south, are facing hot and windy weather on top of already tinder dry land.
Not a good recipe, you know, to put together. Add an ignition from a firework or a controlled burn that's been left to smoulder. It's only going to be a recipe for disaster for the community.
Slowly, over the past few years, fireworks have disappeared off many shelves, with major retail chains like supermarkets and The Warehouse no longer selling them. Overall, demand and profits are down.
They're quite a difficult product to handle. They're expensive to manage and to store. They're obviously a dangerous good. There are lots of restrictions on how they can be sold, and I think all of that has meant that fewer people are buying them over time.
Fireworks can be purchased by those 18 and over for 4 days over Guy Fawkes, but there are no restrictions on when they can be let off.
When they're up for sale to anybody, they just keep going on and on and on. It's the sound and noise just causes intense fear, anxiety and distress. And for many animals, they do not understand what's going on.
The SPCA speaking up yet again for a shift to public displays only, keeping both people and their precious pets safe under the lit-up skies. Donna Marie Lever, One News.
And we're joined now by Kim Baker-Wilson in central Auckland. Kia ora, Kim. We've seen what fireworks can lead to in Christchurch. What precautions are there in our biggest city?
Well, Auckland is taking no chances, and the Maunga Authority responsible for the guardianship of the 14 mountains in Auckland, those mountains that the city is so well known for, says there is very good reason for that. Large major blazes in the likes of Mount Eden, where I am tonight, Mount Wellington and in Mangere in years gone by. It doesn't want to see those fires happen again. So there's only a little bit left for people to come and walk up these mountains because the gates shut at 7:30 at night. That started when fireworks go on sale. It'll come to an end at the end of the weekend. The Maunga Authority says there is very good public support for this, and the evidence is there to back it all up. It says there has been no fires during Guy Fawkes in the last 2 years. It's also choosing this time to reiterate its call to ban the public sale of fireworks. It says it's left with simply no choice but to completely shut off access to the public at night because of the enormous damage that fireworks can do.
In Tāmaki Makaurau, Kim Baker-Wilson, Tēnā koe.